Hi viewers, so welcome to this World Machine Tutorials. There was a lot of request by so many viewers to prepare a video on this World Machine. This World Machine, it is used for some artistical painting like things. The thing is that we can create a number of terrains and we can customize all the things and we can make very beautiful things in a very little or very no effort, I can say it like this, okay? So let us have a look at this, what is this World Machine and what it can do and what are the latest versions we are using. Then we'll go for this hands-on how to create beautiful terrain using this World Machine. Okay, so especially who are taking this game development and who want to study this lesson as a, I think, the game development, for them this World Machine, it is very essential. Even if some people who are having this artistic idea and all things, they can also prefer this World Machine. So from this you can clearly understand this World Machine, it is a terrain editing tool. Terrain, you can create a terrain and you can edit it. That is the main idea. And it can be used to determine the overall appearance and characteristics of this terrain. So the difference appearance, you can see it here, a hill is there, you know, what are the things are there, a fall is there and everything there. So everything you can also create and you can also edit here. Okay. How you, if you have visited any mountain or a terrain, then you can clearly visualize what you see there, the same thing or better things also you can create it here, right? So then I was learning and I was commenting, maybe the Lord Brahma or so, he knows this World Machine because he has created so beautiful mountains and these terrains and all things. Without the simulations, creating all the things directly, it is impossible. So maybe the entire credit goes to the Lord Brahma, who has created this beautiful universe and where it is full of beautiful terrains, mountains, hills and etc. Okay, once again I thank you and I welcome you to this one. Then here, if you come to this World Machine, it allows the generators and effects of the to create and details of appearance of your world. Okay, the world, whatever you see, the beautiful mountains, the hills and all things, the same thing also you can generate and you can also give the various appearance to that one. And this way, the working and thinking of a higher level takes some getting used to, but the rewards are very huge. Okay. And you can create impressive terrains with relatively little work or no work, I can say. And once you have created a terrain, that you can use it in various other places also, right? So then coming to the World Machine 2, which is the successor to this World Machine, okay? So it is keeping all these basic options of this World Machine and some additional features and ability, whereas the basic things are also it is preserved. There is no difference to that one, right? So these are the some of the things that are there. Then if you know that we have something like that, computer graphics and all things are there, then but there is a trade-off. You try to understand this thing. The trade-off in computer graphics is for the usually a lack of control over terrain features, placement, etc. So what are the terrain features and is the placement? You can just copy paste and something you can do, but you cannot, you don't have any control over those features. But World Machine 2, in the layout mode, it allows you to work in a more artistic fashion, plotting out of this terrain as roughly, as precisely as you like, and the ability to determine for yourself the level of control you wish is one of the great new abilities available to you as in the statistics. Okay, so now till now we have understood this is the importance why we are going for this World Machine. Now this is enough theory. Now let us go to the World Machine. Okay, so now we are using some versions. If you want to see the versions, I can see it here. So about the World Machines, I am using the very old version, that is World Machine version 2.3.7, that is the professional 64-bit site license, etc. Okay, then return to the program. In the initial stage, you will be looking while you double click on this World Machine 2, it will come like this. So you can start a new project and you can do all things. You can see it here, this is there to start a new project, okay, and this is there to open an existing project, and this is there to save, and this is here to export terrains, and this is your world extension and resolution also you can do it here. This is the different preferences, and here you can go for the randomization, and different views are there. This is the device view, you can press F5 button. There is the layout view, you can press F6, and you can go for the explorer view, that is the F7, and here is the 3D view, that is F8, okay? So these are the things like that. You can have 2D view also, F9, right? So 3D it is F8 and 2D is F9. So then you can go for build option, it is like this. Then you can go build to current devices and also title build, like that you can do all things, right? So up to this you have seen. And here in the tools, you can use, you can tools, favorites, macros, generators, output, combine, filter, natural, selector, converter, parameters, flow control, all the things we can use it here. Say, suppose I go for this generator, okay? So welcome back. Now we are going to start these things, and I explained you that whenever you are going for creating a new one, we can start here by clicking it here. You can go to the new, just we started and used it here, the new one. Okay, so we created a new file. In this new file, so existing some things are there. You don't worry for these things, just select everything and you press it delete. Okay, so it will ask you, do you want to delete it? Yes. Then after that, individually you have to delete all the things. Select, delete, yes, select, delete, yes, then select, delete, yes, then select, delete, also it is yes. Okay, so now you have successfully deleted. Now you try to understand, first time when you created a new file, in this new file by default some things appeared there. So first of all, you selected everything and press delete. It is asking you the option whether you want to delete. You pressed it, yes. Then individually you deleted all these 4 items what you have sent now. Just select and delete, select, select, select it. Okay, how do you select? So with your mouse, with left click on that particular thing, you select it, then you press delete button, then it will be ask you to whether you want to delete and all things, okay? Now when you are going to first time create something, then you see here, we are having a number of tools here, you can see it here, and one of the tool is the generator, okay? So first we start with the generator. So I have clicked generator, and you can see so many things under there. Under this generator, you can see what is the first one. First one is the layout generator. What is the second one? Perlin noise. Third one is the advanced Perlins and the constant. Then is the gradient, the colors. Then the radial gradient. Then the so many items are there. Okay, I think all of the things you will not be using there, but we will be using now the advanced Perlins. Okay, so now we have to click this advanced. So I clicked it here, then drag and put it here. Okay, so now you click it here once. Okay. I selected that one, I selected this one, clicked there, then pressing the left button here, drag it here, put it here, and then clicked one in the left click, then I am putting the right click here. Now you can see it here, right? And you can make it the size, etc. You can make it bigger or smaller, all the things that is possible, that also you can do here. Now what you have to do, you are already there in the advanced Perlins. You double click there in the advanced Perlins. You can see the various properties here also. Okay, the advanced Perlins, you can see it here. What are the things you can see here? You can see a lot of features. You can see first one is the feature scale. In the feature scale, see how your terrain looks. Whether you want more boulders, you drag this one, this slider here. You want hills, you put it here. You want mountains, you put it here. You want continents, you put it here. Okay, so now whatever the things you want, that you do, I want something in between hills and mountains. I want something between hills and mountains. Okay, if it is hills, you can see it here, and if it is like this, like this, like this, and hills are there, mountains are there. So I put something like this here. Okay, hills and mountains. Okay, so these are the things you can find it here. Then it will ask you the basic parameters. In the basic parameters, we have options. You go for the smooth. Below, okay. Can you see it here? We are having basic, we have rigid, we have glowy, we have smooth. All the things are there. You just go for the smooth below, okay. You have gone for the smooth below. Then we have octaves, and now we are not worried about these things. Then I come here, that is the start setting, whatever setting you want here. So you, I think it is at this moment you don't go for these things. It is not necessary for you. Then you can go for the transformations, because here I the 4 kilometer by 4 kilometer, instead of 4 kilometer I go for 8 kilometer by 8 kilometer. Okay, 8 kilometer by 8 kilometer. You can visualize all the things. So back it is 8 kilometer by 8 kilometer. Okay, so now the smoothie below 100%, all things are there. And random seeds, what is this random seeds? So what exactly you want here, because this is just randomly since you generated, because it is one which is created here. Suppose I go for a new random, so you can see on the left hand side it is changing something. Again I go for something different, it is also changing. Again I go for something, it is also changing. So like that, it goes on changing. Okay,
then the elevation center and the stiffness, that also it can be done. But at this moment, I don't think you have to go for those things. It's not necessary at this moment. Okay. So then what you have done? So first you selected this feature scale between hills and mountain. You fixed it here. Then you have gone for these basic parameters. Style, you put it here, smooth below E. These are the things you have done it here. Then you have come here to the right hand side. Then you come for this transformation. In the transformation, you put it 8 km by 8 km. Then these are the things you have done this. Okay. So you can see it here what I have in the generator. So I am going for this advanced structural Pauline generator. It's just related to height and all things. You can see it here. Right. Then everything is okay now. If you want to do other things, that you can, once you learn all the things, then you can do gradually. Okay. For the time being, it is okay, and click it okay. Okay. Now your advanced Pauline, all the features you set it. Right. So now you are ready. Go to the next step. Yeah. You can see it now. We have little modified our things. If you see the various things here, parameters are here. The octave and persistence, it is there as it is, don't touch it here. Then coming to the elevation centers, you it is around 13 to 1500 degrees, some of you set it like this. And the stiffness, you put it around 0.53. So this random set, you can change it, the different things it will appear it here. Then activity it is 0.0 and offset it is 0.0. Gain it is around 0.5 and lead-in levels it is 1. And then the type it is coming signal level. So now what you have to add, only the important things you have to remember, that we have gone for this transformation, that we are covering 8 km by 8 km. That is the one piece, it is 8 km by 8 km that we are covering. Okay. So all the things and starting setting is the same. So with this, what we do, we just press it okay. So once we pressed it okay, now our advanced Pauline is ready. Okay. So once your advanced Pauline is ready, so that means the generator, we created the advanced Pauline and we have come up to this, right? So now we move to the next one. Yes. Just after that, we can go for a number of filters. What is the job of these filters? Let us understand here. So I click it the filter. Once you click this filter, you can find a number of options here. First one, it is the clamp. Second one, the simple transformations, terrace, curves, all the things are there. Just I go for this clamp. Click this clamp and drag and drop it here. Okay. So now you can see I have the clamp here with me. Right. So in this clamp, if you check it here, if you double click on this clamp, you can find a number of things are there. You check it here. The clamp is related to, it is the decreasing height and increasing the surface. Okay. What do you mean by decreasing the height and increasing the, some hills are there. Top of the hills, etc. I want to decrease the height, or the bottom, no, the terrain, no, the floor surface I want to increase. So the clamp is used for that one. So for doing these activities, I have gone to the filter and I have selected this clamp, and in the clamp, selecting this clamp here, so you can see it here, I have done these things and it is there. And I don't think it is something you can put it here, and here also something you can take it like just like that you can go. But what is important for you, it is important for you the clip. So selecting the clip, what is this clip, what it is there, it is used for flattening all the things. It is used for flattening these things. So for flattening these things, what we do, so you will see it here. So we'll be using like this, it is here, something here, or something like here, yeah. So we put it and press it okay. And you see, till now, you are unable to use anything here. The problem is that this advanced Pauline, by selecting this one, so you have to go for the build. Once you build that one, you find the color is changing from yellow color to green color. Previously it was some yellowish color, this one. Now it is the this color. Okay, what is the purpose of this color, that I will explain you. See, we have three colors. One is the, you can see it here, one is the yellow status color, one is the red status, one is the green status. Green status means the device is properly connected and built results and exist for these devices. That means you already build it. When you build it, it is coming green color. Yellow means the device is properly connected, however it has not yet been built. You get it now. So red status, the device is unconnected. So initially it was red color because it was not connected. And then when I have gone for this, you know, I click that button build, then it has got converted into green status. You see it here, what has happened there. So yeah, you just come to this one. So now if you come here, we can see here initially this one, it was red color. Okay, now it has converted to green color. Now it is bigger. How I build these things? Just selecting this one here, I click this one. This is the button for the build, and this is for build to current device. This is for title build, but we are not bothered about these two. We are only going for this build. So I click in that, it was there. Now, when I have gone for this clamp is related to, I told you that three things are there. One is the clamp, one is the clip, and another is the expand. Okay, one is the clamp. Clamp is there to decrease the height and increase the surface. And clip is there to flatten things. And another thing is there also expand, that if you want, then you have to take a number of clamps like this. So I have taken one clamp here. This is, you can see this is the clamp. So if you want terrace, any that is different, the different issue. Now what I have to do, just click it here. And then you connect to this one. Okay, then you connect to this one. With this, you are already connected to the clamp. That means the clamp, the color it is showing now, you can see the yellow color. Yellow color means it is collected, but it is not built. Okay, now double click this clamp. You can see the adjustment of height and everything you can see here. When I'm adjusting this height, you can see it here. So you can see, you observe here, the surface is coming up. Okay, so I little reduce. You can observe the surface is still, it is going down. Now if I put it the minimum, the surface is naturally what is there as it is, that you can put it here. Okay, so clamp is for that purpose. And here also what you can do here, that also you can put it here, right? Okay, so that is the thing. So in this, just you click it. Okay, now you have done this one here. Now suppose at this stage you want to check what is the output, you want to see these things, then how do you do all the things? Just click it here. When it is clicked it here, then you have to go for the 3D view. Okay, for 3D view, what is the 3D? F8. When you go for this F8, you can see it here, it is looking like this. It is looking like this. Okay, so now you want to come back to the previous one. So press F5. Press F5. When I'm pressing F5, I have come down here. Okay, so what I'm telling you, that if you you want to see the 3D view, just click the 3D view. For this 3D view, what I have shown you, it is the 2D view F9 and 3D view is F8. F8, just pressing F8 in your keyboard, then you can go for this 3D view. Just I clicking it here, I click the 3D view F8, then you have seen that one. And what is that one? That you can see it here. Again, I'm putting it here. So function F8. So you can see it here, it has come here. Okay, and drag and drop it here. You can also, yeah. Okay, this also you can rotate, and this also is not working. So this also you can see it here. Everything what you want, you can check it here also. Okay, let it like this. Okay, so now I want to come back to my previous one, then function F5. Okay. That is because my keyboard is different, so I am going to the F5. Okay, now you put the clamp there. Okay, now the what is the third point? Third point, I have to go for this terrace. Okay, third point, I want to go for this terrace. Okay, so now before going for the next step, yeah, now you can see it here. So what you need to do it here, because if you want to put all the things, the different filters, then for clamp you have to put one, so for clip you have to put one. For expand, you have to put it one. But this purpose is different. While I am going for the clip, I already told you what is the purpose of the clip. Purpose of the clip is to flatten. And the purpose of the clamp is to reduce the height and increase the surface. So if these things you are doing, then you can put it separately. So this is just a preset, okay. Now you can put it here. Now you can see it here. Now, just after this, what you want? See, I want the terrace. See, to drag all this, what you do? Just you click the right button. Click the right button, drag. Left side, right side, you can put it here. Okay, or top and bottom also you can do it here. Everything you can do it here using this right key, clicking the right button. Now first you have gone for the clamp, second one is the, then you come to the terrace, click it here, drag and put it here, the terrace is here. Okay, so if you click it here and right click it here, now the terrace is there. Now in the terrace, what you see in the terrace, you can find it here. So the terrace method will be by default sharp, but you have to make it smooth. Okay, so here the number of terraces are 7, but you make it around 4 or 5, so I make it 5, okay, and I enter it here, then again I double click, 85 there, and terrace that sharpness is 0.87, layer equal to 1, so this is there, and here if you want to change anything, dense packed, dallas packed, platyus, subject layer, all the things it is there, you no need to touch it now anything at this moment, so it's okay, okay, then anything x and y, I'm not doing anything. for set B option is there. So now I press it OK. OK. When I press it OK here, then you can see it here. This, the terrace is also ready, right? So now up to this, what I've done, I save it here. OK, I save it, and for this thing, then because auto save is there, so what I need to do next, we'll see the next step. So now we have seen the property of this terrace. In this terrace, we just converted this into smooth. Initially, it was there some sharp. Okay. Then we have got the number of terrace, it is 5. And terrace shape, or you have given some 0.87, or you just 0.82, 82, like that, you can put it there. And terrace layers, it is 1. So everything is okay. Okay. Then we can go for a connection from this primary output here, click it here, to the primary input to here, it is a terrace. Okay. So coming to the terrace, you have seen here all the things I have already shown you. Okay. Then immediately after the terrace, we go for this erosion. Okay. So okay. Then where you get this erosion? Erosion, for this erosion, you have to go for this natural. You see, first we have gone to the generator, there we have taken this advanced polyols. Okay. Then we have gone to the filter. From this filter, first we have taken this clamp, then we have taken this terrace. Okay. Right? Now we are going for this natural. In the natural, we are having first one erosion, second one is there, like that, so many things are there, snow is there, post erosion is there, but we go for this erosion here first, right? Okay, so put and fix it here, erosion, it is here, okay? So now it is here, and right click here, okay? So this is the erosion part, it is there. Now, in this erosion, if you see it here, we are having standard erosion, no filter, then erosion, base duration, it is okay. Everything is there. There is no need to do anything, any change it here, I think. Then you go for this geological enhancement, it is not required. So scale independent accounted, it is there as it is. There is no change here, I think. Okay. So then just you click it OK, and you go for the connection from this primary output here to the primary input erosion here. Right. So in this erosion, now you can see it here. So if I just let me check what are things that are here. So here it is there. No. Blended. Okay. So erosive power is there, it is as it is. Okay. So now we can check it here. So we have selected this erosion, click and drag it here. In this erosion here, the terrace, click it here and put it here also, the primary erosion here. And in this erosion, double click here, you find it here. The standard erosion is there, and erosion filter type, nothing is there. So here everything is okay. Here just you enabled all the things, and here it is coming 0.5052, like that, something like that. Then you are going for this scale independent recommended, it is here, okay? So with all the things, just you press it okay. So once it is there, now the erosion part is over. Okay. So once the erosion is over, once erosion is completed, you have seen that in the erosion what you have done. In the erosion, just we enable this one, and here it is 0.50 to 0.52 something, you can put it here, and you selected this scale independence. Okay. Once this is over, then you click it okay, and after that we are going for this macros. Okay. In this macro, if you see it, this is the macro, and what you need to do, we just observe carefully, just to click it here. Once you click it here, you will find the different things. One is the coverage library, one is the mask tools, natural effects, non-term examples, outputs, river tools. So you can have the surface maps. So like that, a number of things are there. So you go for the surface map, okay? So in this surface map, okay, in the surface map, what you need to do, just you select the, I think you have to go for the basic coverage. You have to go for the basic coverage, okay? So once you go for this basic coverage, you remember one thing, you are not selecting this one, don't select this one. Just you click it here in the basic coverage, then load macro. Remember, you don't do this mistake, because what they do really, they select it here, don't select it here, don't do it like this. What you need to do? In the surface map, just select the basic coverage here and load macros. Okay, so then you put it here and right click, it is there. Okay, now the basic coverage is there. Now what you have to do it here, if you see it here, we are having four outputs here, and here having on two outputs. Okay, so then what we have to do, we have to use some combiner. Okay, so for combiner we can use this combiner. Just I select this combiner and you have to go for this this type of combiner. Okay, select this one, drag and put it here, this one combiner, and click it right to here. Now what you need to do, this last one, okay, this select this last one and drag it to the last one, this one. Okay, then select this one and put it into the this one. Okay, so yeah, just you do this undo control Z, so it has done. So control Z, okay. So I don't know. So it will be done. Right. So what we have done here now, up to erosion it was there, and from erosion we are having four outputs, and from this we connect the last one. Because for four, you are only having two inputs, so you cannot connect all the things. So what we need to do? So we go for this combiner. Use a combiner. Where you get this combiner? You are having a combiner here. Select it, drag and drop it here, and put it this combiner. And this last part one, put to the first one. The last one, put to the last one. Okay, this is that. And this output you connect to the this one. And this one directly connect to this one. So this is just about the basic coverage macros. Basic coverage. Macros. Okay, then you are going for this output here, and in this output you are having so many things, and you can go for the height output, you can mesh output, bitmap output, and overlay view. So you go for this overlay view, drag and drop it here. Okay, okay. So in this overlay view you can put it here like this, and you before proceeding to the next one, just you it's okay, just one. Then immediately we can go to the here the output, because we want the output from this one, isn't it? So in that case, how we go for this output? In the output, just to select the bitmap output as well as the height output. You can see it here. It is here. Then if you see here, this is the text output. The height output, you drag and put it here. One height output here. Select. Click it here, then when the bitmap output, drag and put it here, click it here, right click it here. So these are the two things we are putting it here. So one is the height output and one is the bitmap output. Okay, so overlay view we are giving. So now you set it up to this, and we just wait for a minute. Then what we do usually, just observe it here. We have taken output to outputs. One is the height output, one is the bitmap output here, and one is the bitmap. Where you get this output from this output? So this is your text output. Click it here. This is the text output. This is the height output. This is the mesh output. This is the bitmap. I clicked it here, and one bit output I put it here, and one bit output I put it here also. One bitmap output I put it here. Similarly, the height output also which is here, the height output here, that height output I put it here also, okay? So now, what I have done, from this erosion, I am giving connection to the height output. From the erosion, I am giving connection to the height output. Similarly, from the basic coverage, I have given to the bitmap output here, and from the basic also, we have given to the overlay view here, right? Now, we have to do one more thing. We have to go for the converter. In the converter, you will find something. Okay, let us see what it is. The coverage, then the normal, then the splat, then the channel, then the channel combiner, colonizer, like that. So you have to go for the normal, okay? So this, drag it here and put it here, something like that, it is here, okay? So now write it clear and put it here, okay? Now from this normal, we have to connect, I think this connection you have to give it here. And now from erosion, a connection has to go to the this point, okay? So for this, you just save it here, okay? So now you have to provide a connection from this erosion to this one here, and from this point to this point here, and similarly, and you have to give a provision from this erosion, this point to this point here, right? So these are the things it is done here now. If you check it here, I think you have nearly completed all things, right? So now what you have done, you can have a look on these things. First we started with the arrangement purlin, then we have gone for the clamp, okay? For beauty purpose, I just clamped, okay? Okay, so this I put it here, then I put the terrace here, then the terrace I put it little like this, then I put the erosion. From this erosion, I have gone for the basic coverage micros, and from the basic micro coverage, because we are having the erosion, we are having two things here. One is the your wear map and another is the deposition map. And third one is the flow map. Flow map we are not using it because for river and all things you can show that one. So this wear map and this is for deposition map. So deposition map we are going for the combiner here. See why the thing is that I told you that we use for the erosion. Why you go for the erosion? We are using a terrain tool. In this terrain tool, we are going for this picturization of this terrain, whatever you see the naturally. Do you see that the earth is constructed yesterday or day before yesterday? It has taken billions of years to come to this earth. So in this billion of years, there is a lot of erosion. It is weathering is there, it is exposed to sunlight, it is exposed to wind, it is exposed to so many things are there. Okay. So this is we call it as a weathering. So in this, some erosion on the top surface is eroded. So some smoothness it will appear, that not softness will not be there. So that is the reason we are going for this erosion. Okay. And while we are going for this terrain, the terrace, I have gone for this erosion. In this point erosion, we are having four outputs here. You can see that this is the primary output, and this is the flow map output, and this is the wear map output highlighted in the right field, and this is also the deposition map. Deposition, you understand what about sediment, etc. It will be deposited on the floor. So like this. The last two we go for the combining, because here only two input it can take it here. So we combine these two with a combiner. Where you get the combiner? So we have to select this combiner. We have a combiner here. In the combiner we selected drag and drop it here. Okay. Then once it is over, then we have gone for this basic coverage that is coming under the macros. Okay. In this macros, if you see it here, you click this macros and you drag and the basic coverage macros, because you particularly the name also it is highlighted there. And you don't worry what you have done here, everything else it is written here. So first, if you check it here, first one is the advanced purlin, then is the clamp, then is the terrace, then the basic coverage, combiner, erosion, then is the overlay view, the height output, bitmap output, and normal back maker. Okay. So these are the things it has, up to this it is there. Okay. So now I hope you have completed all things, and this you can save it there also. You can save it here also. If you want to see, this is already in the project 3. I saved it here, project3.tmd, by default it is there. So if I, so another one also, you see it here, open, go to the 2D, here also. Here we'll find the similar type of things that are there also. It is done, the two is combined here and is going here. And this one is going to the normal map maker, okay, normal map maker, then with bitmap output. Then height output, then overlay view, and bitmap output. Okay. So to see the output of all the things, then what you need to do? So first you can build it, and if it is done, then you go for this F8. What is the 3D view? So F8. Okay. F8. So you can see the F8. It is here. Right. Clear. So you can see the F8 here also. Okay. So like this. Yeah. You can see the 3D view. You can clear it here. And if you want to see the water level, then you just click it here, the show. You click it at the show, and you can increase the water level here and there. Yeah,
sleep here, but I think I suffocated. So it did not come here. Yeah. So something like that. Yeah, it is, up to this it is better, I think. Yeah. Then you save it here. Then you save it here, and you can make it like this, and you can look here. And all this you can see here, right? So this is the case, and now I save it, and you can see it here. What is the so ACTE, that is the advanced Berlin plan terrace, then erosion basic coverage combiner, that is overlay view bitmap BHBN. Okay, BHBN. Okay, up to this it is there. So then I save it here, and I go to the file, and again I open this now in another file, that is the 3. Okay, open the same thing. If you want to do it, then first already you have built it. Then I go for this placing a plate or the 3D view. Okay, the 3D view you can see it here, it is looking like this. So in this 3D view, you click it here first, and if you want to put the water table also, yeah, that you can put it here. Something like that, you put it here, and then you save it here also, right? So this is the thing which you can clearly see, and you have created a beautiful terrain like this, right? So this is the thing which I have given to you. I hope all the students will be able to follow it. If they find any difficulty, they can do mail to me, and I will be telling some of the basic commands here also. These things you have to remember. See. So to drag this one, what you do, right click and you make it left and right and up or down, or that you can make it here. Okay, so then if you want to select left click, you put it here, click it here, that you can do it here also. To see the 3D view, select that one and you go for the F8 or 3D view, and for the 2D view you can go for the 2D view F9. Okay, and for this build you can press this green button. Similarly, for the layout view, so suppose I want the layout view, so the entire layout it is appearing like this, right? You can see the layout view. Okay, so you are here, and the entire layout view, you can check it here, the view it is coming like this, right? So all the things you can do it here like this as you like. So then you come back to your 2D view, 3D view, the 3D view also you can copy like this. So now I hope I have given you the minimum things. You'll be comfortable preparing this type of things, and you please do send your comments and feedbacks, and also do like to this video, so that I will be able to prepare some advanced version of this thing also. And I hope with this we have clearly explained So thank you for watching this video, and please send your comments and feedback also. Thank you.
Yeah, welcome back. Now, with this, we can do all things. So just you go to the overlay view. Here, okay, everything is okay. Then you just go to the 3D model. That is the height output. Height output, just rename it 3D model. How you do, just right click and rename it, reset it. They will ask you put 3D model, because this is the height, it is just the 3D model, and the bitmap what you are using at the bottom, it is just the color. Okay, so this is the color map we say. So for this, what you need to do, only thing you have to do it here, you select the save. You can check it here, you select the save one, and here initially it was in the PNG format, but you have to convert it into raw 16. You have to go for this raw 16. Okay, raw 16 was there. I think you have to convert to PNG format. Okay, this is one thing. Then you come to this one, and here we have to go for this PNG. It is in the PNG, and what you have to do, you have to select this one, and this one, right? Okay, and where you want to write the output file, you just put it in the desk, or you give the path where you want to put it there. Similarly, for this one also, you do the same thing. So PNG 16 bit, and you put to all these three, you select it there, then you click it OK. And where you want to save it there also, OK? And here also, it is there, OK, it is there, no change it here. So I have shown you everything it here, and instead of raw 16, that you convert into PNG, PNG 16, OK? So raw bit, you convert to PNG, OK? So raw system there, and you have to select it, save it as PNG system. So with this, what you have done, you have completed everything. Okay. So then, okay, then what you need to do, save all the things. For saving everything, you know, you are having it here. Just you click it here, it is saved here. Okay, just saved it here. And and after this, we can just wait on it. Yeah. Yeah, 1 minute. Now, two things you have to observe. Okay. So, one is the normal, that is the bitmap output. Okay. And the second one is the color, that is also bitmap output. So, in this normal, just hold it here. So you have to see that the file format is 16 bit. Okay, and you have to select all this. This I told you, this is okay. Then you have to go for this color. Here also the same thing you have to do it here. Okay. Once it is completed, then you come to the word extents and resolutions. Once you click it here, and you will find something like this here. One tick mark there, that untick this one, and by sliding here and there, you make it 1024 by 1024. This is the only thing you have to see here. Then you press it OK, and then you save it. OK, then OK, and then you just build it. OK, for building all things, you can click this one, build. OK, once it is built, it is showing it has built it here. So now, build. OK. Okay, then it will ask it is okay. Okay, build status, build completed. Okay, then it's okay. Then you can check it here. All those files, whatever the files I put it here, those files should be saved at the desktop, because I wanted to put it at the desktop. So you will have files like, you know, first you are having the color map file, second one you are in the normal map, then in the landscape. Okay, so all these three files are available here. And you can use all these files for your convenience in the unit. Okay. So till then it is goodbye. We'll be going for one more video on this unit 5.6, how to use all the things. And take care of all. Goodbye to all. And also, you don't forget to give your likes, dislikes, as well as the